Hey everybody, Xavier Thorne here, and welcome back to EG. It's time to get right into Sector 8. Last time we had a not-so-exciting fight with a Sentinel. Could have been better if we had more ammo and that ammo had more power to it, but it didn't. And we didn't. So, it didn't happen. It's Dan. I just took out some kind of Kamado security robot. It was really... Yeah, not so much. All we did was kick it into some electric... I'm just going to say pylons. It wasn't pylons, but I'm going to say pylons. But I hope I didn't waste too much time. Good job, sis. And it's alright. I think we're relatively safe, but you have to push on and get to Sector X. The Tazen lifts are starting to run out of power since the Kamado arrived. This is Sector 8, and the Kamado have built quite a defensive force here. Be extremely careful. Got it. Oh, and those sounds around my control room started again, but it sounds like some rats in the ventilation. I'm not worried anymore. That's good to hear. Moving out. Whoop! Stuff down here. Never mind then. This one goes. Or not. Okay, either way, I'm gonna have to kill someone. Then we have ourselves another trouble before. Tired of parasites eating your nails and breakfast. Being nibbled on by those pesky little glints. With Litaway spray, all your worries will be over. For now, get a free assassin class laser weapon. No, we will be aggressive and there. Has not been tested on the if it hasn't been tested, it's a problem. I had my fingers on the wrong keys this whole time. I just need to kick, change weapons. No, you died. Owie! Ouch. Ow! Son of a bitch. I've lived. Where are you going? Okay, yeah, this is your time to stop. I know that. You can't fool me. I know what's gonna happen with that. Oh, yeah, I know. I know. Luckily, with the knockback, I can easily dodge the blowback down. Lucky I can't kick you! Ah, watch it. Split. Ow. Oh well, only one damage. Tank. Stop it! There, you can't see me. Oh. So much for that. Come on in there. I don't think I can come back once I leave. I really don't think I can come back. You guys have a ribbon in there? Yeah, it doesn't look like it. Yeah, I can see two lights from here. How far does this really go? A bit further, so... Oh, it is possible. It's gonna annoy the hell out of me unless I think I'm fine. Wait, man, I hate these. No! Wait for me. I just want the ammo! Stop it! Damn the flip. Nope, nope, stay away. Annihilator! The rumors have just been confirmed. There are indeed annihilators in the Modern Assault Games. Who knows why they brought them? We're doomed anyway. Probably because they get a kick out of being slaughtered. If I ever live to see one of those walking tanks, I'm not even gonna fight it. I'm just gonna stand there and let it kill me as fast as the easiest way possible. Oh god, I knew that would happen. Annihilator! Now, something like this. You guys kind of fight each other. Oh god. Hi buddy. Wanna help me? Hate you. Okay, asshole. That helps. Hey. Okay, that teleporter there, I can go back. Just stand here and let him kill himself. Hey, come on, blast me. Blast me. Blast me. Fine, go fuck yourself. As long as you're not to be trifled with, I'm working on myself. Oh god, another one. No. Excuse me. It's going down here. How are you not dead? Ow! Okay, that was just me. You're going to die, sir. Not quite appreciated. Come on, just die already. I need stronger guns, but I need my strength up first. Might as well do this. There, we have a way back down. Not back up. Oh, jeez. Man, I'm getting slowed up. No! Yeah! Okay, there's a teleporter. Hi, how you doing? One more thing. Hey, I'm gonna stand here. Here. Hey! Fine, play it your way. Close combat. Okay. Die! Play it your way. Proximity mine. Gimme, 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 gimme. I want it. Oh, a plant mine. Whatever. No, you just got a trap mine. Right. You can place a teleporter destination like Proximity mine. And press an X. The mine will destroy the teleporter destination when someone tries to use it. Now. And if we remember our little hint from the one room, save it. Summary of History Part 3 is Jason's Battle Room. The fury with which the Battle Imperial Army was strike was beyond belief. Jason's starship was like raided and destroyed, and the number of casualties astronomical as they invaded our home world. Kamado eventually developed a starship class nano called the Alpha Strike, which looks hundreds of stars in the moon with the space ground nano weapon, but bombard the planet with unbelievable power to attack. We then should create a planetary shielding system to defend our world, but even when we finally manage to steal the Kamado's upstream armor, so has they in turn stolen our planetary shielding system. Since then, the only way to wage war on the surface of a planet was with personal combat, with soldiers and attack ships. We were now hunted across the galaxy, and every time a part of our population was planted and erected a planetary shield, Kamado found them, fought them in the surface combat, destroyed the planetary shield, and helped protect the planet. Our population rapidly dwindled, so the consisted of only a million individuals in our very last time. Most of the people were killed. Lift up here. Yes, the brilliant minds who most probably fixed catapulted the flying by once again out of the sun. With a new integrated sound chip of the team, lift music every cycle. Just tune in the chip to the nearest legal frequency, making sure to skip the illegal one, still add genetic features for a global moral arm. And prepare your oral taste buds for the sensation of such unforgettable classics as exploding eardrums that are also on fire. It's awesome being purple. And Halseri will kick you in the face. So don't delay. Order an upgrade for your lips right now and get a free Elite Proterra action figure. Those things are valuable now that he's dead. I need to get over there. If I remember right, I don't think I can shoot the guns. I mean this. Our future, the chances are super deep snake, as we all know, but from that point on, we no longer have a covenant people. We need more of these people, powerful leaders, to keep up with the people together, as internal conflicts should remain in our past. General Tor and Violator Iosa are perfect examples of which we are role models. Tor cares about his people, while Iosa is also powerful. Is so powerful they couldn't even kill him with an Alpha Strike. That woman has a great war record, but her future looks even better. History will treat her well. The more young leaders like her and General Tor we get, the better. Okay. So, yeah, it's gonna happen. Okay, so I could try the regular Devastator, but I think I'll just try the new. Okay, a little more to the right, and I would have had that. Gotta get all the way to the right and then tap slightly to the left. You always launch the opposite direction. Oh, come on! Shit. Trident as well. Let's see what the picture is. No, I do not want a duck to use trap mine. That's bad juju. I will take at least one of these bastards down. If it kills it. I know, oh yeah. Out of ammo. This is going well. These are tough. Ouchie! Stop it. Stop it. Being rude. Why won't you die? Ah, out of ammo. Wrong way. Oh, let's break the shield. Yep, got him. Thank you. Crap. Need a heavy restock of ammo before I take out the other one. Wait a minute, there's a turret there. Getting a thought. We passed the point of no return. Yep. View seems like thinking about the future of our species, and rightly so. We're so advanced, and we've been able to hunt the Tates and clear across Deep Space without a single individual escaping our grasp, at least to our knowledge. With the Alpha Strike, we have have reliable planet killer technology, and the Star Strike may soon no longer be just a theory. Sorry, what? We are the grandest, most organized life form we have ever come across, despite past wars. High Command keeps us together, and we colonize an exponentially accelerating number of planets. It's simply impossible for our race to ever be extinguished if we keep growing at this pace. Back on Origin, we were ruled by nature. But now, the galaxy belongs to us. With the Imperial Army controlling the military branch uncontested, any planet, any species, any solar system High Command so wishes, we can and will destroy if we put the time and resources into it. The motto will be eternal. Yeah, I doubt it. Rude! What's up here? Private! Everyone loves private. Thank you! 8 ribbons. Another ribbon. I've been collecting these a lot now. The only other thing in my pocket is the trap line. Reminds me of a robot. Do you have a cute little? The one they used to save Dan from Holy Wars. I threw it pretty hard. Something tells me I should hang on to this mine until it really comes in handy. I don't need to suspend myself right now. I'll keep it. Though it looks like the batteries won't last past this sector, and it doesn't need to. Right, I've only got 2 more points to get to Strength 9, but if I remember right, I do need to only go to 9. Wait, no, never mind. The thing I'm thinking of. Never mind. Just never mind. Never mind the never mind. Okay, that thing. Ow. Okay, it's a damage at least. Come here. Hey, buddy. Here. Just wanna shoot you. Thank you. No, I want that. Give me. Not so much for that. Rude. Okay. No, stop. Stop doing that. Don't do that. Keep that around. Actually, I do need to put it over to this side. Okay, now the pain in the ass part. See, once you get it over here, if you don't have it in the right position, you have to pick it all the way back. Oh, that's why this bit is such a pain in the ass. Okay. Maybe now I can get it. Actually, no. Okay. There you go. And the problem is, I cannot. Ooh, don't do it, don't do it. Okay. I can't kick it down here yet, because I have to clear out that annihilator, or else it will destroy it. Oh, this is gonna be hard. Okay, get the Devastator ready. I will kill him. Because I gotta get it right there. That's why you needed him to at least walk over to this side to clear out the debris and everything. Okay, we're good. Now we can test the teleporter back up. See? Turret right there. Berserker 23948 78397 45533 for your eyes only. Project 00002901030525 is still Star Turns for mass production. We have not yet managed to fully decipher the documentation of these species that invented it, as they encrypted it, and they encrypted everything as heavily as possible. The only safe way to conceive this weapon is combining an FD Devastator with a cyclic fusion ignition system, which gives us our Velocithor that we already have. Either they did the same, or most of the weapons we have now are simply lesser modules of their opponent's technology. The Imperial Weapons Industries looks to a future where we shape nanotechnology at our will, rather than guessing at the inner workings. The next generation of weaponry may be coming, and a massacre prototype was indeed used on Sirtaco. Until then, this is the best we've got. Wrong button. Alright, we go up here. Now, we can bring this down. Whoop! Alright, anyone wondering about that? When I've been playing Black Flag, anytime I air assassinate someone, I make that sound. My little stealth sound. They never see it coming. Come on. Yes! Ha, right. An Easter egg. Very funny. But most, more importantly, supercharge. We actually now have the available points to max out our strength in this sector. Still, we have an Easter egg. There you go. Take the turret out. All we wanted was the Easter egg. If I could time that right, I could make it look like I kicked it. Good enough. Yeah, see? So, basically, when you kick the turret down here, it should be in the right position that you can just kick it to the right and get it right into where you can be strike. You don't want to miss supercharges if you can help it. Now, we couldn't get the one in the last sector. I've gone over this. Not enough ammo, not enough power to the weapons. But alright. Where were we? Right, we're going this way. The only way we can go. But I remember right, getting full strength will make it so like the Devastator doesn't knock me back anymore. Maybe even the nuke. Yeah, then we still have the next sector and then Sector X to get our attack and assimilate to actually 6 each. Maybe even 7 if we get the supercharges in both areas. So yeah, let's go for strength. Okay, can't grab that. Alright, we have one way left to go. Down. Oh, this. That door and the lift beyond need to be powered up. Use the controls to the left. It might take a while for them to activate, so be prepared to defend that room. Remember, duck on a teleportation destination and press X to set the trap mine. Yeah, we're not doing that. Not in the least. And we can kick things again. Bring it on, bitch. Kick you in the face. Yeah, now what? The Kickmeister's back. Ow. Stop it. Get out of here. Tried to juggle. Ow. Who needs ammo when I can kick you in the face? Ow. Is he dead yet? Yeah. Ah, even you. Or it would be even you. Like, if you hold still long enough, I'm gonna kick you. Ow. We're free to go. Not that I meant, ow. Could you stop? Seriously, this is annoying. Did you guys just die already? I am going to fuck you up. Can't avoid it. Late. Your fate is sealed. You're caught in the kicks. Thank you. Okay, we can't go in there yet. We have to go up. But we can get down there. Lost some health. The important thing is I kicked the shit out of everything. I enjoy that I can do that again. Hi, Jen. Ow! Okay, I can pull strength again. Way to kill yourself, buddy. Can't stop me, fool. Yes. Aw, so close. Stuff down there. I want stuff. How do I get the stuff? Okay, these are in the way. Can I drop anywhere? Apparently not. I think there's a way to activate that lift or something. You could get me. You could find me. Vending machines? Human-made food containers in this area seem to require the use of an elaborate mechanism to obtain their contents. Yeah, kinda how it goes. Some narrow hatches and simple endowed buttons are the only visible ways to interact with containers, save for dismantling them. I guess they're the human's equivalent of vending machines. They are vending machines! Fools! But less sophisticated. Gets me thinking of the ones back on Hatazakora. They had all kinds of fruity stuff, and I don't mean fruity as it contains the crushed flesh of the of an innocent living organism that happened to be born on a tree. I mean, packaging adorned by such brilliant slogans as, it's all natural, so is there poison. Okay, that's my way down. No, not okay. That hurts. What just happened? A second Kamado shit. Just blew up the planetary shield generator with a phantom hammer shot. There's no time to lose. Get ahead for Sector X now. Got it. Just be sure to check the computer terminals nearby. I think one of them... Wait, the strange sound here again. But now it's... What the... damn, what happened? Are you okay? No. Listen close, Emily. I think I know where you're headed. And there's a corridor ahead that I know you must come across one way or the other. Your friend will be waiting there. I assure you, I suggest you get to him before I change my mind. Ready? Go. Motherfuckers. Okay, so it's you. Damn it. Damn it. Luckily, we have jump for days. Thank you. Nano Sprack. The shield, or not shield, but the strength thing. Someone nearby, I need to stay away from that. Yeah, okay, I can't backtrack. I want my last point to set the strength up. Ultra a minefield, run and seek. That sounds fun. Clearly the most lethal game ever created. The rules are really quite simple. First, buy or plant a large minefield, and gather every participant in its center. Then, it is time to choose who will be the seeker and who will be the judge. This is used to decide it with a large fight, of which the two participants with the least bruises and wounds wins. When the seeker and judge have been chosen, they remain in the middle of the field, and the seeker closes his eyes. Then, the other players start running randomly around the field, and whenever someone steps on a mine, the seeker must point out, must point in the direction in which it happened, and guess the distance to the explosion. If he succeeds with a predetermined margin of error, the judge gives him 1 point. This continues until 10 short seconds have passed, at which point any player who is still alive counts against the seeker's points. If the seeker has a positive score, then they can expect a thorough and utter beating by the survivors, who are most probably not very pleased with not having become the seeker at the start of the game. Okay, cybernetic endurance. The cybernetic endurance is temporary invulnerability time after being damaged is reduced by 50%, and you are no longer knocked to the ground by the MPFB Devastator's recoil. Oh yeah! Power! What's down here? Thank you. So, either way, I'm going all the way to the bottom, it looks like. I'm close to the end, but there could be a fight around here. Possibly. Honestly, that big room down there, I feel like there's an annihilator there, and that can take more time than I want to put into this at this moment because of how far along this episode is. So I'm going to leave this episode here. Thank you all for watching, and I hope you've enjoyed it. And I will see you all in the next episode where there's probably an annihilator down there.